Data build tool, popularly known as DBT Core, is an open source framework that simplifies data transformation and analytics engineering, focusing on SQL-based transformations. For Microsoft Fabric, DBT Core enables data engineers and data product managers to create and deploy projects to Fabric data warehouse, offering modularization, testing, and documentation. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install, set up DBT Core, create and run complex CTE-backed model transformations on VS Code. We're going to create a Power BI report using the SQL analytics endpoint of the DBT transformation table to build insight. So let's get started. As I've mentioned, I'm going to be using the amazing Visual Studio Code editor to implement this solution. Now, before we start building anything at all, let's understand the structure of our Fabric warehouse and the data we've got in it. So I'm going to come to my browser, and in the browser, I've got this DBT workspace created, and I've got this data flow that I use to bring in my data into the sales warehouse. Now in the warehouse, I've got four tables. Now we've got this DIM account manager that contains two columns, the account manager's name, 14 of them, and the account manager ID. And then we've got this DIM payment that contains the payment type and then the payment ID, the 13 of them. And I've got this DIM product. Now in the DIM product, we have the list of the product name, and then we have the product ID, we have the price, and then we have the cost. And then in the F orders, that's the fact table, we've got several columns like the order ID, order date, ship date, customer name, and so on and so forth. So this is how our Fabric warehouse looks like. Now the name is sales warehouse. So let's go back to the VS Code and start building the solution. Now we're going to create a folder to house all our codes and all our files. So I'm going to click at the top left hand corner, files, and then I want to go to a folder. I'm going to use my VS Code workspace, and I'm going to create a special folder for this. I'm going to right click, create a new folder, and I'm going to call this one Fabric DBT Project, and press enter to commit, and I'm going to double click and select the folder to go right in there, and this is going to be opened in the VS Code editor, so we can see the Fabric DBT Project. That's cool. Now I'm going to install the Python package that is related to DBT. So for that, I'm going to go to the terminal at the top and then create a new terminal. So click on that, and this is our terminal at the bottom. So let me just move this up a little bit. For that, I'm going to use this code to install the Python packages and the dependencies. So we have this Python space dash m space pip that space install dbt core dbt fabric. Now I'm going to press enter to run the packages. Now this has been done already, so we can see the requirement already satisfied coming up. Now if you're doing it for the first time, you're going to be seeing all the packages and dependencies installed for you. But for me, all of this has been taken care of, which is absolutely cool. Now I'm going to come in and use the clear command to clear the contents in the terminal window. Now I'm going to proceed to initialize our DBT. So I'm going to do DBT init to initialize the DBT project. For now, we do not have any files or anything here, so I'm going to press enter. So as soon as I press enter, I'm going to be seeing the first arrival of some files such as the logs. So when I click on the, you can see the dbt.log. So we're going to provide the name for our project. So for this, I'm going to call this one fabric underscore dbt underscore project. You can use whatever name you like, it's absolutely up to you. So I'm going to type that here, and then I'm going to hit the enter on the keyboard to commit. So we can see we have quite a lot of information, and then we have this API modeling, which is really cool. So setting up your profile, we need to connect to a specific database to use. So we have these options like the Databricks, Fabric, Snowflake, and Spark. So for this demonstration, we're going to be connecting to our Fabric. So we can see that, don't see your connector, you can go to this URL and check for the list of available connect adapters. So for that, we're going to be using our Fabric number 2 adapter. So press enter. Now, unfortunately, we do not have any sample file found for Fabric. So this simply means we have to build all of this by ourselves. Now, before we go on, you probably noticed that we have this arrival of this Fabric underscore DBT project. And then when we expand, we have all of these components of DBT. We have the analysis, macros, models, and so on and so forth. Cool. Now we're going to go ahead and build this project. So it is really important we create a profiles.yml that's going to contain all the list of our SQL string, the name of our database, and the kind of connectivity we're going to be using. So for that, I'm going to go right into my C drive, and I'm going to go, this is my C drive, right? So I'm going to go to the users, and then I can click on this. So I'm going to click on DBT, and for now, we do not have this anything in this .dbt. So if you couldn't see this .dbt, just right-click, create a new folder, and then click on this folder, and then just name it .dbt, all right? So .dbt, okay, and then press enter. But because this is already there for me, I'm just going to use this without having to recreate it. So click on this. Now, I'm going to paste this profiles.yml. Now, this must be named profiles, not demo. So I'm going to go ahead and rename it. I'm going to get rid of the demo. So it must be profiles.yml, and this must contain all the credentials in order to be able to authenticate to our Fabric warehouse to double click. So for that, we have some information to specify. Now, we need to provide the name of our DBT project that was specified not too long. And then for the target, we can change this, but I'm going to maintain this Fabric dev. And then for the output, I'm going to maintain the same Fabric dev. Now we need to use the command line as our authentication, and then we need to provide the name of our database, the name of the host, and very importantly, we need to have this open database connectivity driver 18 for SQL or 17 for SQL installed. So either 18 or 17 is fine. So if you don't have this, you must install it. Otherwise, you will not be able to authenticate to the Fabric warehouse. So for me, I've got that in my program. So I'm going to just provide the name of the database and the name of the host, and I'm going to maintain this DBO schema because all the tables are right within my default DBO schema. So for the name of the database, I'm going to come here to the browser, and whatever is the name here is the name of your database. So mine is sales warehouse. I'm going to go right into that, and I can get rid of this placeholder value, just delete carefully and paste, or let me just type in sales warehouse. I couldn't paste, I don't know why. And then for the connection string, I'm going to come to my browser again, and then we can click on this get settings, and I'm going to see this SQL endpoint, and then we have this SQL connection string. So we can copy this to the clipboard and come back to the VS Code editor. Oh, sorry. We're going to come back here and get rid of this connection string placeholder, carefully delete and paste, and that's sorted. Now I'm going to just move to the left, and as I've mentioned, I'm going to maintain this DBO, and then the thread is going to be 4, and then the type is going to be Fabric. Now after you've done all of this, I'm going to press, oh, it is important I change this, okay? This must reference the Fabric underscore DBT underscore project. So I'm going to type that here, DBT underscore project. So this must correspond to the name because it's actually part of the dbt underscore project.yml. So I'm going to press Ctrl S to save, and that is all you need to do. You don't need to do anything other than this, okay? So once you press Ctrl S to save, I'm going to close this, and that's fine. Now for now, when we issue the dbt debug, we're going to get an error because we need to ensure that dbt underscore project.yml is connecting to the profiles.yml. So for that, we're going to actually cd into this Fabric underscore dbt project. So how do you cd? Just type in cd, and then I'm going to type in the name of the project, Fabric underscore dbt project, and I'm going to press enter. As soon as I press enter, I can see I'm actually now within this folder here that includes all of this artifacts, and the very important one is the dbt underscore project.yml in order to be able to authenticate. So once I'm there, I can issue the dbt debug just to check for my connection, whether everything is working fine or not. So I'm going to just wait. Amazing. So everything is turning green, which is really cool. So when you go up a little bit, you can see that the profiles.yml is found, and it's also valid. Sometimes this can actually result into some error for you, and you may be struggling on how to figure out what's wrong. And then the dbt underscore project.yml is also found, and it's also valid. And then the required dependencies, the git is okay. So we can see the connection, the server name, the database. We can see the client ID, authentication, the CLI, and so on and so forth. Absolutely cool. So after we've done this, we're going to move to the next step, which is to build our models. So to build our model, which is the core part of this video and DBT for me, I'm going to come to these models, and for every DBT project, we have this default my first DBT models.sql and this my second DBT model.sql. So this allows you to just play around to test how we can deploy or run these models. Now, if you're actually focusing on this, you probably never understand how we can set up your own, build your own models and run them successfully. So I'm not going to focus on this. I'm going to get rid of these delays because I actually want to show you everything so I can understand, you can have a very good experience on how you can build your own models. Now, for every SQL file, we must have a corresponding JAMA that contains all the corresponding description of the column, the table, and so on and so forth. Again, I'm going to get rid of these and I'm going to show you the whole thing. So I'm going to come to these examples, delete. Now you can see we do not have anything. So I'm going to show you how to build all of this. Now I'm going to right click and create a file. Now I'm going to call the file sales_analysis.sql. So this must end with the SQL because we're going to be using this to perform our transformation. So I'm going to press enter. So for this, we're going to also create another file, and this must be named. I love to use the same name. This is going to end with .yml. So sales_analysis.yml. So for the YAML file, we're going to be providing the name of the column, the name of the table that we are working with, and that's going to actually help us to be able to run our models successfully. So I'm going to come into the sales analysis and I'm going to just paste up this code and walk you through the whole thing. So okay, so when you look at this code for the first time, you're gonna see we have this curly bracket at the top, the two curly brackets and another two curly brackets, and then we have this config open bracket materialized equals to table. Now this is a configuration sentence in DBT that specify how the resulting data set will be materialized, that is saved in the database, our fabric database. And this materialized equals to table means that the query will be created as a physical table in our database when this DBT model is executed. Once created, it won't change unless we explicitly rerun or rebuild the entire model. So that's what all of this is doing. DBT actually works with the common table expression, not the standard SQL. So we can see we have this with keyword, and this with this with keyword, we have the name of the city, which is orders, and then we have this as keyword. Now we are selecting all the rows from, now we have again this two curly brackets and these two curly brackets. So this is how we reference the name of our warehouse and the name of our table. So we have the source equals to the name of the warehouse, and then we have the name of the table, the F orders. Now when you come here, you can see we have this F orders here, so I'm not performing any magic. And we have another city, the second level product, this is named product. As we are selecting all the rows from the DIN product table, our dimension table, and then when I move this down a little bit, we have the sales by product city, and then we are selecting some of the columns from those tables. For instance, we're selecting the order ID, product ID from the orders table, and then we're selecting the product, cost, price, unit from the product table and then orders table. And then we are performing some calculations like multiplying the units by the price, which are in respective tables, two columns in different tables, and this is aliased as total sales. And then we are using the from, so from orders, and then we use the inner join to join that with the products, and then we use the on keyword to bind the product ID across the product ID using the orders and the product table. So this is how the first query is going to look like. So after we've done this, it is important we also have the corresponding information in the sales analysis YAML. So for that, I'm going to paste this code. So when you look at this code, we have this version 2. Now don't worry about this. And then for the source, you're going to see that we have this sales warehouse which correspond with this sales warehouse here, which is cool. And then we have the schema, which is DBO, and then we have the tables. Now, in this case, we are working with just two tables, the F orders, and then I just provided a description, which is a fact table containing the sales orders. And then we have this DIM products, that is this table, and this is just the description. And then we have the models. Now, this is the core part. So our models is named sales_analysis, exactly what we've got here. This must correspond in order not to cause conflicts. And then we have the description, combines orders with product details to calculate total sales per order. And then we have the columns that we're using in our model. So we have the order ID, I provided the description, the product ID, the product name, This should be product, not product name. So I'm going to just type in product, and then we have the cost, price, and so on and so forth. So we have the total sales. Now, total sales is the calculated value for the total unit, or units multiplied by the price. So this is looking good. Now, I'm going to go ahead, and you can see this needs to be saved. I'm going to press Ctrl S to save, and I can just come here again, save. So I want to make sure that everything is saved. Okay, cool. Now we can go on and run our first model. All things being equal, this should give us a successful transformation. So I'm going to just issue DBT run command at the bottom. You can see I'm going to press enter. Amazing. This completed successfully, which is absolutely fantastic. Now we can come back here and I can close this for now. I can refresh my warehouse. As soon as I refresh at the bottom, we should see the table. Let me just refresh this and let's see. Amazing. So we can see that I'm able to query the sales underscore analysis, which is exactly the name of our DBT models, which is cool. Now, I don't know why the Fabric is actually giving me this error, you know, but it's actually in telling me I can actually query, but I don't know why. So our DBT model is actually working as it should, which is absolutely fantastic. Now we can go on and build Power BI report on top of this data. We can see we've got all our columns, such as the order ID, the product ID, product name, the cost, price, unit, and the total sales. So when you come to the VS Code, you can see the same number of columns that we selected in our CTE, which is cool. Now I'm going to quickly go to a blank report in Power BI instance, and then I can use the one link to connect. So click on this catalog, and I'm going to connect to my warehouses, and then I can at the bottom right hand corner use the SQL analytics endpoint to connect to that sales analysis. So I can see that here, sales warehouse. Now I'm going to click on this and use the SQL endpoint. But when I try to connect live, I'm going to get an error, you know, due to some settings in my tenant. So use the SQL endpoint, and then in the navigation dialog box, we should be able to see all the list of our tables and all the other objects. So I can see the sales analysis. I can click on that, and I'm going to just see the preview of the data. I can take it into the Power BI for transformation, but that's not needed. I can just load into the Power BI data model, and then in a matter of seconds, I'm going to start building my report. Now, for the connection settings, I'm going to use the direct query. This simply means that the query will be sent to the source and then brought back into the Power BI without having to load the table into the Power BI instance physically. So once that is sorted, I can see the table. And of course, we're not going to be able to view the table because this is direct query, not import mode. So we have all the products. Let me just see the products by total sales. So you can see it's actually spinning because the Power BI is going to send the query to the source, the Fabric warehouse, and then wait for some couple of moments to get the result back to us. So let me just turn this to a table, and oops, where's the table? Okay, cool. And then we have our value. I can apply currency formatting to this to make it look nice. And we have our implicit measure, and we can also, you know, see the total sales maybe by, okay, let's do by products. Okay, now let's just play by product. That's the only column we can use to filter for now. So let's say we want to see this using the clustered column charts. There we go. So everything is working fine. So this is how we can implement data build tool using Microsoft Fabric warehouse. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, like, comment, share, and follow me for more videos. I'm going to put the link of the profiles.yml in the description box so that you can actually use it if you want to practice this on your own. And please make sure you subscribe to the channel because there is a lot to come. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.